In this tutorial, I'll show you how to seamlessly switch between different cameras, add cinematic yet simple animation to each angle, and as a bonus, also morph between those cameras to create energetic animation between 3D layers. First, let's quickly review the project I'll be using. This composition originated in Illustrator, where I wrote the text "Make him cry" using the Sai font available through Adobe Fonts. I converted the text to shapes for better control when extruding it in After Effects, and I also added a drop symbol and a simple frame. To transform these shapes to After Effects, I've used Overlord 2, and this tool is just fantastic. Though not directly relevant to this tutorial, I highly recommend for you to check it out if you're interested. So in After Effects, I extruded these shapes and duplicated the logo and the drop a few times, applying different treatments to each one of them based on the stroke settings, specifically the width, the bevel, as well as the offset path operator. This approach creates a multi-bevel look that I can animate for each one of these elements along its Z-axis. I should mention that for this example, I'm using the Cinema 4D renderer, but you can also work with the Advanced 3D renderer if you like to. To give a better view, I'll orbit the camera and move the CTI so you can see it from a different angle. And if you want to learn more about this technique, watch one of my previous tutorials, the link is down below. Towards the end, I animated the individual path of the M and the Y letters, as well as the position of the drop. For color accents, I tinted the second and third point lights in pale yellow and light cyan, while point light one remains white and casts shadows. An environment layer is also included in this comp to enhance the reflections. Now, to preview the final look, I'll switch off momentarily the Draft 3D mode, and this will show us the full effect with the reflections and the shadows. There's also an audio file with cue breaks every 2 seconds, which I'll use to time the animation. And now, let's begin animating it. So first I'll undo a couple of times until I'll return back to the previous state where the logo is facing me, and I'll take the CTI to the beginning. I'll go to the layer menu, and under new I'll create a new camera. I want a cinematic look, so I'll choose a 24mm camera, but you can go with whatever settings you want. I'll click OK to generate the camera, and I'll start to look for an interesting angle. Now, to walk faster in After Effects, you can hold down the Option key here on the Mac, Alt on Windows, and this is going to change your cursor to the camera, the unified camera, by the way. And assuming you have a 3-button mouse, you can use the left mouse button to orbit around the scene, and then you can use the right mouse button to track into the scene, so effectively changing the zoom. And then the middle mouse button you can use to do the panning. So what I want to do is just look for an interesting angle over here. I want to maybe orbit a bit more and also zoom in really tight. And I think this is going to work for the first angle. Maybe just lower it a touch down. Now, assuming you're happy with your first angle, let's create a second angle. So my audio guide is going to change every 2 seconds. So this means that I'll take my current time indicator to 2 seconds, and then I'll select the camera, I'll go to the edit menu, and I'll split the layer. And this is going to create another camera, which is basically looking the same way. Now for this camera, I'm going to choose another angle. So again, I'll hold down Option, Alt on Windows, and I'm going to move my cursor over here. I want to be under this little dot and maybe also come from a different angle. And again, I'm just looking for an interesting angle that doesn't really expose what is written on screen. All right, I'll move now to the 4-second mark and I'll repeat the same process. This time I can do it from the keyboard. So holding down Command, this will be Control on Windows, Shift and D will split the layer. For this camera, I'll hold down again the Alt key, and I'll pan down to the area of the K in the word make. I'm just trying to find something that looks interesting that will also demonstrate and show us all the reflective parts of this logo. Just to illustrate what I mean, I'll switch off the Draft 3D button and let After Effects render the final image so you can get a sense of how it's going to look. All right, I'm happy from this angle, so I'm going to do the same thing over at 6 seconds. So Command Shift D to split the layer, and then while holding down the Option key, I'll pan up until I can start to see the word cry. I can orbit around the scene, maybe choose a more interesting angle. I want to be very close to the letters, but still not expose what they are saying. So something along those lines. Now, if I'll go to the beginning and press spacebar, since we are using the Draft 3D mode, After Effects will be able to preview it in real time, so you can get a sense of how the animation is going to look. Now, obviously, at the end, we need to show the entire thing, and I also think that we need to animate between the beginning and end of each camera. And to animate this camera, I'll go to the start of the layer by pressing the letter I, and then I'll double tap the letter U. UU in sequence is going to show me the modified properties. I don't care about the camera zoom, so I'll twirl it up, but I will create keyframes for point of interest and position. Then I'll go to the end, I'll hold down Option, Alt on Windows, and I'll track all the way until I can actually see the logo. So maybe even more, not maybe, for sure I want to drag more and find an interesting angle that will complement this logo. So maybe something like this. Now, for the last keyframes here, since they are already selected, I'll press F9 to easy ease the animation. And I'm also going to visit the graph editor and make sure that those keyframes are selected and just change the influence, which is the speed. Let's just preview it to make sure the end animation is very slow. Again, let's preview it from this point. Great. I'll click again on the graph editor to return to the regular keyframes view, and then I'll repeat the same steps for each one of those cameras. So I'll select camera number one, double tap the letter U to see the point of interest and position, which are the modified properties, create keyframes for them, press O to go to the out of this camera, and by holding down Alt, I can temporarily toggle the camera tool, and then I'm just going to orbit and maybe just zoom a little bit out. Actually, I want to see this little cylinder here, so I may also pan up and orbit around the scene. So no big moves here, I just want to try to be gentle and expose part of the logo. Let's go to the beginning and then check it again. I don't want to see this cut away, I just want to make sure that we can see the entire shape. Excellent. And now I need to repeat it for the other cameras. So I'll speed through this process because this is practically the same thing. Pressing I to go to the beginning of the layer, double tap the letter U, create keyframes for the point of interest, press O to go to the out, and then just changing the camera angle to something which looks a little bit more interesting. You can zoom in and then just find something that looks cool. Now let's go to the start of the comp and preview to see how this looks. Now you do want to keep all the keyframes linear except of the last one to maintain a consistent velocity or speed throughout the changing angles in this animation. Now, instead of hard switching between those cameras, we can also morph between them, creating a smooth transition between each angle. To achieve that, I'll go to the start and I'll duplicate the first camera, and then I'll drag it above everything and rename it Camera Morph. I'll press U to see the keyframes and extend the duration of this camera until the end. Now, what we want to do is select each one of the different cameras, press U to see the keyframes, and then copy them to memory and paste those keyframes on this camera. And to do so, I'm going to select those two keyframes, hold down the Option Alt on Windows, and using the left cursor key, the arrows, I'm going to move those two keyframes and then paste So the morphing animation is going to still respect the 2 second cue, and it's going to be very fast. So this is how it looks. Now you can extend the duration between those keyframes, totally up to you. Let's do the same thing for the next camera. So I'll press U to see the keyframes and then mark key around both of them, select and copy them. I'll return to my morph camera, select the last two keyframes, hold down the Alt key option on Mac, and then using the left cursor key, I'll move those two keyframes and then paste the new ones. And let's preview it. And if you think it's too fast, you can just select those two keyframes and just make them further apart. So let's see how this works. It's a bit more gentle. I do feel that the morph should be quite quickly. So something like this, almost like a cut, but still create a very fluid, dynamic motion. I'll select now the last camera, in this case, camera number 4, and repeat the same steps. So I'll copy those keyframes and then select this one, nudge those keyframes a bit to the left, paste the new ones, and then let's just preview and see how this works. Now, this may be a bit abrupt depending on the angles that you chose. So to smooth the animation, you can select all the keyframes except of the last ones, because I don't want to mess with the easy ease over there, and convert all the other ones to auto bezier. And you can do it by holding down Command on the Mac, Control on Windows, and clicking on one of those keyframes, assuming everything is selected. And this is going to make the velocity, the speed, equal on all of those keyframes. So this is going to look like this. Almost like it is breathing a little bit before going to the new angle. And now we can switch off the Draft 3D button and go to the beginning and preview the animation. So this is how it looks with the cuts between those cameras. And this is how it looks using the camera morph technique. Now you can apply this simple technique to any 3D extruded logo or text, creating impressive camera movements in After Effects in seconds without the need for complex rigs, null objects, or plugins. The key is to make it look great and synchronize it with your audio. And that's it. Now, what do you think? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. If you find this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and click on the bell icon to stay updated on more cool tricks coming very soon your way.